So the kids and I were out for a bike ride today, and we stopped by a place that had some stuff out on the end of their driveway with a sign says free on it. And we found this. So three NES controllers in various stages of cleanliness, but the buttons aren't especially sticky. And an Atari 5200 controller, which is in shockingly clean condition. All the buttons work and everything. So I sense a project coming on. So here's my plan for this project. I've got three of these classic NES controllers, like you saw in the beginning. This is the most beat up looking one, so that's my experimental guinea pig. From here, got to do a bit of research, and so far what I found is the output pins on this guy don't actually correspond directly to the buttons. Some, like the original Atari, it was a one for one between the buttons and the pins. This one, not so much. It is actually a shift register inside this guy. And so there's what I found online is it's a 4021 shift register IC in there, which basically takes 8 lines in, and then on the connector here we have data clock. Where's my pin out? I'm just getting this. We have ground up there, VCC. This would be easier if I hit on the point with, wouldn't it? And zoom back in again. So I got ground up there, VCC. Shift register clock, shift register data out, and shift register latch. And these two are for other serial data out, which is for things like the Nintendo glove and the light gun and stuff like that. But I've discovered in here that those two pins aren't actually even populated on this one, so not a concern. So, a shift register should be fairly easy to deal with an Arduino. For my experiments, I'm going to use the standard Uno, which I fortunately just got a new one of not that long ago. But for my final version, I can't use the Uno because I want to convert this guy into a USB device so I can use it with any computer. And the Uno cannot emulate a USB input device for a computer. Oh, yeah, USB input or human interface device. But the Digispark can, and so can the Leonardo family, which includes the Pro Micro. Not the Pro Mini, that's different. The Pro Micro uses a different chip. Strangely, the Digispark uses a ATtiny 85, which is a close cousin of the 328 that's on here, but it has in its libraries, and probably some magic in the Digispark bootloader, it can pretend to be a keyboard or a joystick or something like that. I think I'm not going to use it though, because it doesn't have a hell of a lot of processing intelligence on board, and it's not super fast, and it doesn't have a huge pile of memory. Which leaves us. I could have used the Leonardo, but I don't have one, so that leaves us with the Pro Micro. But for now, I'm going to just use the Uno. So the next thing to do, since I don't have a mating connector for this, let's figure out how to do that. And I've been poking around, and I've found that this 18 gauge solid wire fits pretty well in there, actually. I put just a little tiny eek bit of bends on it. I'm not sure whether you can see that. And that makes it fit just nice and solid in there. So that's my next thing, is to take an 18 gauge wire and cut it up into some chunks about precisely approximately that long. That way you can get the signals out of there. Give them little bits of bends, nothing too extreme. I need everything down this side. And I need that guy over there for, what is it? That one's VCC. So, ow. I'm just going to go away for a minute and cut up some jumper wire and solder it to those and hook it up and I'll be back. And watch. This is just the experiment. Yes, it's ugly. I'll be cleaner when I get into the final product. But right now, I'm just experimenting. One question I see on Ask Electronics on Reddit quite often is, what should I use for jumper wire? Should I go and buy one of those kits from AliExpress or eBay that's got all these DuPont jumpers? Yeah, those are handy for working with breadboards and stuff. But if you want specific custom lengths, just use telephone wire or Cat 5 stripped down. That's exactly what this is. It's just old telephone wire. It's like 22 gauge. Nothing magic about it, nothing special. So, quick strippage. VCC, which will be 5 volts, which is Mr. Cross-Eyed. That one, yes. Green ground. One of those two. Now then, the example codes that I'm finding say to use latch on. Okay, so the latch is the middle one there, orange white. And you can use them anywhere, but it says latch as pin 2, so let's do that. 0, 1, 2. You generally want to avoid 0 and 1 on an Arduino, because 0 and 1 are the serial in and out, or the serial transmit and receive, which are connected to your serial chip, in this case, CH380, 380, 340. CH340. And also to your programming header. So, I mean, you can use them, you just can't have them connected to stuff while you're programming. And since my programming tends to be very iterative, very trial and error, it's just too much of a pain. So, if I can avoid using those, I will. Anyway, clock to pin 3, and clock is the blue one. Anybody who's watched any of my videos so far will realize that I do tend to tangent. And this isn't intended as a how-to video. I don't really do how-to videos. This is more of a, you're watching over my shoulder while I'm doing something. Okay, so that last one, that is the serial data out, and that is on pin 4. Okay, now then, I'm going to have to track down some sample code, and throw that into here. Why is that not in the frame? Throw the sample code into this guy, and I guess probably I'll just modify it so that it throws the reply up onto the screen, I guess. Anyways, I'm gonna stop here, go and tinker with code for a while. I'll be back. Okay, here's everything all connected up. And in the code, the A and B button toggle the LED, which is on D13. B button shuts it off, A button turns it on. You can't see that. Now you can. A button, B button. That's what we want to see. So, what this code does defines the three input or the three pins that go to the NES plus power and ground. He sets up an LED pin, sets up some kind of controller data, which I don't understand yet. Serial begin, because that's always useful. And then sets up the two outputs, the clock and latch, toward facing the NES controller's output, sets up data in as an input, sets up the LED as an output because that just makes sense. And then writes the latch and clock high just to get started. Creates a function here called controller read, which basically sets the latch and clock low, then flips the latch high, delays a little bit and sets the latch back low. Then does a digital read of the data pin, and then does a quick loop and pulses the clock. What are we here? 1 to 7 times, and each time reads the controller data into the data in, and that's it. And then writes the clock back low, pops it high again. So that just pulses the clock and reads the from the shift register that's in the NES handheld. Now in the main loop, run that controller read function, which loads up 8 bits from it. Then do a serial print line to the serial monitor. Here's the reference of what the buttons actually do. And then just if the controller data is this, then write the LED high. If we it's this, we're at it low. And 0 1 1 1 1 1 is the A button, and 1 0 1 1 1 1 is the B button. Anyways, so serial monitor. Here we have it just sitting there, nothing's happening. So up, down, left, right, select button, start button, B button, A button. A button puts a leading zero on, so it bumps it all over there rather than printing the leading zero, which is goofy. And I'm just looking over at my Uno, and when I'm hitting A and B buttons, that LED is toggling on and off like it's supposed to. That's awesome! So that's good. And in the code, everything seems to, all the buttons dump out to the serial monitor as they should. One aside here. When I had this sitting on the bench earlier, you notice that it had the cord all wrapped around it nice and tight. Don't do that. See this knot over here? That's as straight as I could get it. You're buggering up your cord if you're wrapping it tight on there. Wrap it into a nice loose coil, or just leave it sitting straight if you have to. But if you do that, then you've created this kind of a mess. Public service announcement. Don't do that.